a very good evening to what has been a dream start for the host nation, Thailand, here at the AFC Under 23 Championships. It's Reeman Roshan here reporting from the Rajamangala Stadium in Bangkok, where the home team, Thailand, convincing 5 goals against Bahrain. I mean, Roshan, you were saying this, that even the most optimistic Thai fans did not expect this.
Yeah, I certainly don't think so. I mean, I think the element of control that Thailand showed in this game was absolutely fantastic. And, you know, just listening to some of the Thai fans just chanting at the end of this game here, I think really appreciative of the efforts of their side. I'm sure the players appreciative of the efforts of the fans who showed up here to cheer them on and to support them. It puts them in such a great position in the group. But just the display, the confidence that they showed, the tactics were absolutely superb. I think, you know, that front four, Supachai, Supachok, Supanat, that young man getting 2 goals for himself as well, and showing so much composure and confidence in their play.
Yeah.
I got to mention Anon as well, in one of the wider positions. That front four and the fluidity dropping off the lines,
yeah.
Supachok especially having that freedom to roam into certain areas. I touched on it at halftime, you know, getting in behind Bahrain's defence, dropping off into behind Bahrain's midfield and linking Thailand's attack together. Supachai as well doing a really good job playing that number 9 role, working very hard for his team, very hard for his teammates. He deserved a goal, he didn't get it.
Yeah.
And then you have a player like Jaronsak coming on from off the bench and helping himself to 2 goals with pace to burn. And then again, you asked me the question at halftime, what do Thailand change about their game here in the second half? And I said they don't really need to change anything because the opportunities will come. Bahrain will have to open up, have to chase that goal, chase that equaliser. And Thailand just hit them on the break, hit them on the counter-attack. And I mean, 3 points, yes, but done in such convincing fashion. 5 goals as well. Absolutely outstanding night of football by this Thai side.
Yep. And of course, the coach for the Thai national team, Nishino, he is no stranger to, you know, having success at international level.
Yes.
You know, he's brought his home nation to the 2018 World Cup knockout stages. Do you think he can, you know, finally replicate this success with this young Thai squad, especially, you know, coming off a not very successful SEA Games?
Yeah, you know, it looks good, right? I mean, they've gotten off to a really good start. And there was some reaction with his lineup on social media. A few question marks here and there. But I think, you know, the lineup that he chose, you know, obviously players getting an opportunity, they didn't disappoint him at all. We touched on the fact that front four looked really good. Also in midfield, I thought Kritsada and Sorawit were fantastic. You know, did their jobs really well, was so disciplined in those central positions. Clever usage of the ball. Really good at winning it and making it very compact and difficult for Bahrain to break Thailand down through the central areas, forcing Bahrain into those wider positions. You know, I just think overall, the tactics, obviously, at the end of the night, they won 5-0. Tactics were spot on. But the way they played, the performance, you know, was very encouraging, you know, to take into games coming up against Australia next and then Iraq. And, you know, it looks good. It looks very bright for this Thai under-23 side, especially as you mentioned, after the disappointment of the SEA Games.
Yep.
And you know, perhaps in the build-up to this, results not quite that fantastic, and there wasn't that much optimism, I would say, from most parts. But I think, you know, suddenly now, people will look at this Thai side and say, after their performance here, wow, I mean, they're going to trouble the other two sides in this group as well.
Yep. And speaking of Bahrain though, what do you think was lacking in their opening game, and how can they improve on their next game versus Iraq?
Look, is this the same Bahrain side that I saw in qualifying, where they, you know, were quite comfortable in the group, didn't concede in the 3 matches during the group stages, during qualifying? And, you know, they come into this and, you know, touched on the fact that they have players who have experience winning the West Asian Championship, winning the Gulf Cup with the senior international side. And I just found it difficult to believe that this was a Bahrain side that, coming into this tournament, looking confident, having a nice string of results, some good experience in there. I just didn't see it at all today, which was a shame because, you know, again, I picked them up. I said, you know, they would bring a good level of performance. But you didn't see that. That zip was missing from their game. Absolutely no rhythm. There was no intensity. And they just didn't seem to be able to keep up with Thailand's movement, Thailand's structure, Thailand's shape, and just the quality that Thailand had in those attacking areas.
Right. Earlier on in the day, the first Group A match, it was between Iraq and Australia. It ended all square, 1-0, one all.
Yeah.
what did you think of the performance of both sides? Because you weren't too impressed
no,
with
no,
the game overall, were you?
I thought it was a scrappy game overall. I think, you know, thankfully we had this game from Thailand to give us a bit more excitement. You know, it was really good. One all, two fantastic goals. Piscopo for Australia and Mama Kassim for Iraq. I think it was a deserved result in the end. I don't think either side looked very good, looked fantastic. Yes, Australia had a lot of possession and they did try and break down a very deep, very compact Iraq defensive block. But you know, there just wasn't enough cutting edge, enough quality. Perhaps it's just first game jitters, but feeling each other out a little bit. And hopefully for fans of these two sides, their teams will grow as the competition moves on, but they don't have that much time. So it's going to be a couple of days more before they're in action once again. So they've got to get it going, especially Australia coming up against this very fluid-looking Thailand side.
All right, so I guess with that, the way the Group A stands right now, Thailand on top with 3 points, followed by Australia and Iraq, and then Bahrain with no points at all. And we're going to quickly now review games from game day two.
Yeah.
Group B's and Group C will be kicking off their campaigns. Mm. Let's start off with Qatar versus Syria. Now, Qatar, they did lift up the AFC Asian Cup this time around last year. The same manager, do you think they can replicate that success with a younger squad?
Yeah, I think it's going to be challenging. I think there are certainly players in there who get a decent amount of game time in the domestic league, and who will come in and look to try and make a bit of a difference. Hassan Ahmad is one who will be hoping to have a good tournament up front for them. Yusuf Abdurizak is another one in there. And then, of course, they got someone, you mentioned the Asian Cup, the senior side, Tariq Salman, who was a big part of Qatar going on and winning that thing. I was very impressed with him in that competition, in that Asian Cup. And, you know, he will be someone who brings in a lot of composure into this Qatari team, brings in that experience, and expect him to be obviously one of the leaders of this Qatari side. But Felix Sanchez, he comes in, he's got that experience of winning the title. Obviously, it's a completely different thing now with the under-23 side. I'm looking forward to seeing how they actually get on here once they kick things off.
And in the next Group B game, it's going to be at the Tamasat Stadium as well, Japan versus Saudi Arabia. Now, the coach of the Japanese team has been sort of almost criticized by the fans for picking maybe a less experienced side versus a Saudi Arabia side that has 8 full internationals at their disposal. So how do you see this game swaying then?
I think it's going to be a really good game. I think it's going to be such an intriguing game between two sides of really good quality. If there is criticism of Moriyasu, I think it's a bit unjustified because of the depth that Japan have overall. It is scary when you think about the sort of players that they can call up and players that have been left out. For example, Kubo's not here, but he might be at the Olympics. Hiroki Abe is not in the squad, but he might be at the Olympics as well. And they still have players like Mishino in there who can make a difference. Tanaka in central midfield who will be dictating the play for them in those central areas. So actually, when you look at the squad and when you think of the depth that Japan have, it's incredible, it's amazing, and it's a fantastic example of what development is and what it should be. You know, you've got this massive pool of players that you can call up, you can send different squads to almost different international competitions. You've got a different squad going to the Copa America, you've got a different squad going to the Toulon tournament. So I still expect a very high level of play from this Japanese side, and for Saudi Arabia as well. Very good players, you mentioned players in there that already have senior international experience. I like to keep a lookout for someone like Mukhtar Ali and see how he gets on with them. Firas Al-Baraikan as well, someone who's very talented. Abdulrahman Garib, again, someone who can, you know, perhaps be brought on to the consciousness of the bigger audience here. And let's see what happens in that game, because I'm certainly looking forward to a high-quality contest.
All right, also taking place on game day two is Group C, and they call this the Group of Death. Defending champions, Uzbekistan. They've got some of the players from the last tournament also included this time around. How far do you think they will go, and can they replicate that success again this year?
Yeah, if they do, they will be the first side to retain their title, and it's fantastic because we're just about to get the Thai players doing a lap of honour here. Fantastic, the Super Chai had a really good game early on. And you know, they're going around, they're giving their fans a bit of a greeting, but okay, let's go back to focusing on our games tomorrow. Yeah, you know, this is Uzbekistan with players who have been there 2 years ago, winning the competition. Yak Sheboev, someone in that side as well. Koji Akba Alionov in those defensive areas. Yeah, you know, they will have the quality, and they're coming into this in very good form. Their warm-ups, their build-up to this, they've been playing some good football. So I expect them to be one of the favourites to go on and get out of their group.
Okay, and moving on to the next game in Group C, it's of course Korea Republic versus China. And is it fair to say that Korea Republic Republic are the favorites in this group. You know, having sort of like a young squad, player that's also from the Bayern Munich Academy in that
Play for Freiburg now, yeah, Jung Woo Young. In there looking to, you know, there's been a lot of pressure on his shoulders, I guess. So, you know, this is an opportunity again for him to, you know, just step up and show us all what he's got, how he's developed his game in the Bundesliga. Over there, Lee Dong-gyeong is another one to keep a lookout for. Kim Dae-woo in those attacking areas. It's a very good Korea Republic side. I mean, come on, they'll always be there or thereabouts in Asia. You know, they're one of the better teams here.
Yeah.
And again, I'm expecting good quality from them. And they should probably beat China in that game. I think, you know, yes, China traditionally seen as, you know, always thought of as one of the big powerhouses, but in Asian football, but the performances and the results haven't quite been there over the last few years or so. So I'm expecting Korea and Uzbekistan to be the two sides that would probably go through from that group.
All right, thanks for that, Roshan. We will be watching those games very closely. And we'll be there at the thick of the action, giving you all the reports. For all the latest updates, do follow us on AFC digital channels. Until then, take care and goodbye.